I'm Edmar Gerrison, and I'm the Director of the Office of Science and Engineering Labs here in CDRH. Within the office, we have about 125 scientists and engineers who have a broad diversity of experience, from microbiologists to experts in artificial intelligence. We are all dedicated to promoting innovation for the development of new life-saving medical devices. It is vital for our regulatory colleagues to be able to assess the safety and effectiveness of new devices as quickly as possible, and not to delay the introduction of novel technology for patients. A key part of this is keeping well informed of advances in material science, digital technology and advanced manufacturing, and all the other technologies that go into novel medical devices. A little known fact is that CDRH scientists and engineers are actually at the forefront of pushing these technological boundaries through our own research programs. Here are a few examples of the research that OCEL is undertaking to support public health. In our Division of Applied Mechanics, we are assessing the potential for high-intensity ultrasound to treat cancers without the need for drugs or radiation, as well as developing methods to test heart valves more rapidly and accurately. Our scientists in the Division of Biology, Chemistry and Material Science are interested in how new materials interact with the body and are also studying, for example, how to rapidly test that multiple-use surgical instruments are sufficiently clean and sterile prior to use. Our Division of Biomedical Physics have developed a computer-based anatomical human model, which allows us to understand how modern high-resolution MRI scanners may affect implanted devices such as pacemakers. They've also been looking into how easy it is for patients to use their artificial limbs for everyday tasks, so that future designs can be even more user-friendly. In the Division of Imaging, Diagnostics and Software Reliability, we partner closely with our colleagues in radiological health and are looking at ways of reducing the radiation dose for patients having scans, modernizing mammography scanning, and even starting to conduct clinical trials entirely through computer modeling. This is just a tiny snapshot of some of the major advances that are happening here every day in CDRH, and we are proud to be playing our part in improving public health.